Alright guys, Wyatt here. I recently graduated with a master's in computer science and taught a couple Java courses while enrolled in school. And what we're going to be doing for the next 12 weeks is going through some different labs to help you guys learn as well. So what we're going to do to start this week is we're going to download the IDE, the environment that we're going to be working in. We're going to learn how to set up a project, and we're going to set up and run our first project. So, without further ado, what IDE we're going to be using is Visual Studio Code. Your IDE is where you're going to be doing all of the coding. It's where you're going to get everything done. It's where you're going to write your Java files. It's where we're going to run them for this. So what the first thing you're going to want to do is go to visualstudio.com and download whatever version you need. Once you have it downloaded, we're going to open that bad boy up and we're going to get started. So taking a look at the lab this week, what the goals are is, one, we're going to understand how Visual Studio works. Two, the fundamental concepts of sequence selection and iteration. So getting started. Some of you have it downloaded now. What we're going to do in creating a new project in VS Code. Step one, on your desktop, create a new folder labeled Lab 1. So it's important that we keep everything together so that way, you know, it's all together. Your stuff isn't going to be all over the place. We'll try to stay organized as best we can. Once we get it open, once we get that new folder created, we're going to go to VS Code and we're going to hit open. What we're going to open is that new lab folder we just created. And now we're here. So, once we're inside VS Code, what we're going to want to do is, assuming you guys don't have the extensions for Java already, we're going to get our VS Code set up. So what we're going to do is hit extensions to get a Java file, Java project started. What you're going to want to search for is extension pack for Java. So again, on the left side of our IDE, we're going to hit extensions. You can copy extension pack for Java. I already have it downloaded. You're going to want to download it and install it. The second one you're going to want is the debugger for Java. Again, I have them installed, but you'll install these two. Once you got them, we'll be good to go. All right, we got everything installed. We're ready to go. What we're going to hit next is the what we're going to do next is we're going to get a new project started. So on Mac, if you hit Command Shift P, or on the top, if you go here and you hit the less than sign, we're going to use this search bar and say Create Java Project. It's the first thing that pops up for me because I recently used it. You're going to select No Build Tools. And we are already inside of this directory. We're already inside of Lab 1. So this is a good place for us to select the project location. All right. Now what we're going to do is it wants us to give it a project name. So a good name for the project for Lab 1 will be Lab 1. Do a capital L. But we're probably going to change the name here in a minute. And what you can see here on the left side of the IDE, select Explorer. That's what we're clicked on here. Lab 1, SRC, and our Java file. All right, nice. Now we got the environment set up and we're ready to go. So part B is where we get to doing a little bit of coding. So we're gonna say you are the owner of a pool that is the shape of a perfect rectangle with the dimensions, width, depth, and depth known. You want to create a Java function that computes the maximum amount of water you could hold in your pool. So copy and paste the code below to the Java file and rename the Java file to PrismWork. The reason why we're renaming it is the file name and class name listed right here need to be the same. Alright, so we're going to copy this code. We'll talk about it in a second. Rename to PrismWork. So when you run a Java file, the first thing that's going to happen is it's going to run your main function. Now, your main function is every time you run a file, this is the first one that gets run. And this is why right now we can hit run and we'll see what happens. So we have a print statement underneath it that says the volume is, and that's all we got. In between, we have length, width, and height variables all set as integers. In Java, everything needs to, each variable has to have a type, and these are all integers. All right, and we're going to use that moving forward. So, in case you don't know how to compute the volume, here's a reminder. And one purpose of the code is to compute the volume of a rectangular prism. Step 2, create a new int variable named volume and compute the amount of water that can be held in the pool. Output it accordingly. Alright? So, similar to how the length, width, and height variables are created above, we're going to create a new integer variable called volume. Here, following the hint, we're going to say volume equals the length times the width times the height. All right? The volume is now in our print statement, we want to add this to it. So now instead of just saying the volume is blank, we're going to say the volume is, working with the print statements, what you're going to do is you can concatenate this string right here to this variable that we just created, volume. And now we have the volume is plus volume. The volume is 30. Alright, we see how that works. Not too bad. Compile the program by hitting run or the play button up top, and we did each one of those. Try your program with various values for length, width, and height, and verify that it always produces the correct output. Your program works properly. Add another print statement so that the final output looks like the following. So here we're just going to change our values. The only one that's going to be changed is the height. So instead of 1, we're going to get 5. It's 5 feet deep, I guess. And let's see if it works. Alright, so instead of, so 10 times 3 is 30. 30 times 5 is 150.
Nice.
Alright, so we kind of are starting to understand a little bit how to use some integers, how to create variables, some of the basic stuff. We know that the one function that runs is main. We know that our class has to be the same name as our file, and we got all that squared away. And now what we're going to do is interact with the user. So change your code so that the user is asked for the length, width, and height of the pool. There should be a statement that prompts the user for each. To do this, you will need to use a scanner. So here, we got the scanner import statement provided. And what this allows us to do is use this built-in package provided by Java that allows us to interact with the keyboard. Alright. So create a new scanner variable to accept input from the user inside the main function. So similar to how we have an integer variable called volume, we're now going to create a scanner variable called scan. So it's of type scanner, the name of it is scan. And to create a new version of it, we say new. And then what kind of variable is it? It's a scanner. And what we say is look at the system and in. All right, so these are some things that you'll start to pick up on later. And for now, just kind of copy and paste it and you'll be good to go. All right. So, prompt the user to input values for length, depth, and height of pool. Hint, use a print statement. So, if you want to think about it for yourself, you can. Otherwise, what we'll do is we'll make a print statement that interacts with the user. So, we'll say system.out.println to put it on their screen like we have it down here. And we'll say input length. Alright, so now we told them to input length. The next thing that we need to do is save the input from the user to the corresponding variable. So we already have a length variable created of type int. So we're just going to keep that same variable and overwrite it. So we're going to say length equals using our scanner. So we have the length variable, we're going to set it equal to our scanner, and we're going to say scan.nextInt. So because it's of type, because scan is a variable of scanner, we said that this is from Java, it has built-in functions. One of the functions is this integer. So when we say scan.nextInt, now the system knows, okay, this is what's coming in. Read the next thing that's coming in and set it to length. Alright, so what we'll do for now is to make sure that it's working, we'll just print input, we'll say input length from user is plus length. Alright, nice. So what we're going to do, we're just going to test and make sure that our scanner is working properly. So we're going to run it. So above everything that we had computed is ran before is running. Now it's saying input length. So it's asking us for the length. We're going to say 10. Input length from user is 10. Nice. So that did everything that we asked it to. That's a good start. Once all variables have been added, compute the new volume of the pool. All right, so what we're gonna do, finishing it off, so we have them inputting the new length. We need the width and the height. So we're just gonna copy and paste and change the variables. All right. Right. All right, so now we're reading in. Let's do some spaces. Now we're reading in the length, width, and height from the user. We can recompute the volume formula and paste it below. Volume users pool is blank. Alright, let's see what we got here. We'll run it one last time. Alright, input length. We'll say this pool is 10 feet long. We'll say it is 10 feet deep. And we will say is 10 feet wide. So the volume of the pool is 1,000 feet. We can fit 1,000 gallons of water in here. Or it can hold. It is 1,000 square feet. Alright, well, here we go. That was the first lab. Wasn't too bad. We learned how to set up a project in Virtual Studios. We added the extensions we needed. We got the project up and running. Started working with some different variables. We're going to look at some different stuff next week. If you guys haven't already, go and hit that subscribe bell. You can hit the notification icon to make sure you're attentive for class next week. Expect you all to be here. And hope you learned a little bit, and we'll learn more next week.